Hello. Am I audible to you guys? Hello. Hello. Okay, so I think we should start, or we can wait for a minute or two. It would be nice if you unmute yourself and talk to me. I'll be presenting the GSoC session alone, and it would be nice if somebody is there to talk to me. Okay, no problem. I think we should start. So first of all, please keep a track of the timeline, because it is very important to not miss anything. You have a plenty of time to get started, because the organization list will be shared with you guys on February 20. You have 5 days. Go out, talk to people, see all the projects you are interested in. I'll be sharing a past year projects link or the archive, which you can see most of the organizations are participating every year. So try to focus on those organizations which are, if you are starting early, like on today or tomorrow, you should keep in mind that only those organizations which are participating each and every year might be participating this year, or they have already listed that they are participating. And if they have been accepted last year, they had been accepted last year, it is very it would be a greater chance to be accepted this year also. So please keep a track of the timeline. The accepted mentoring organization will be published on February 20th. On March 16th, student application period begins. So between that period, February 20 and March 16, you have to interact with your mentors, your peers. You have to work on the project. The work can be any related to the project. By any, I mean you are reading something, you are contributing to the project through solving issues, or you are proposing some new things to the project, or you got the idea. Then March 31st is the application deadline. Before application deadline, I must say you must complete one of the prototype, because you can share three proposals at a time. And keep in mind, if you are in your last semester, if you are getting the degree before April 27, you are not eligible. If you're getting it after April 27, you are still eligible for the GSoC program. So for the application, you are also required to provide a CV. So for the CV part, you can reach out to me if you are not sure how to create your CV. I'll probably help as much as I can. On April 27th, accepted student projects will be announced. So I hope all your projects will be accepted. Then May 18th, the coding session finally begins. I would like to share my own story. Last year, I participated in GSoC. I worked on a project for AMA, which you guys probably know if you are into reading books related to artificial intelligence and machine learning. Sorry about stuttering and bad English. So I just wanted to share with you that in last year, I worked on this project for a Jekyll website for EMA that helps students to work on exercises, and it provides other resources. It will come with the product will come with the messaging system. So Jekyll is a static website generator tool written in Ruby. So it is fully compatible with GitHub. So that's why EMA is using Jekyll. So we were expected to code a website for the end session of the project. Like the end product should be a website with bookmarks. A student can bookmark all the exercises and questions. The student must be able to message, must be able to participate in improving the exercises. So most of the things they required, I implemented before the coding session itself. So I implemented bookmark. I implemented the messaging system. I have shown that how we can improve the pages, links, indexes on the specific words in a tutorial. Like if you are reading a tutorial from chapter 17, if it is talking about a concept from chapter 3, it must show a pop-up, or not a literal pop-up in your window, just I don't recall the name of the thing that just show what is the context of that word. So I implemented all that, but just due to the lack of communication, my proposal was not accepted and somebody else got the project. And the funny thing is, he used all my code I used for the proposal. You can go to my GitHub profile and you can see the prototype I made at that time. My GitHub profile is Deepak Lore Khatri 007. Okay, somebody else joined. Ellie, we are talking about how you can participate in GSoC, and I am giving you some tools and insights because I already tried for the GSoC 2019. I got rejected, but it was not due to the lack of my programming skills or technical skills. It was solely due to the communication skills. So I highly recommend you guys to mail the mentors, participate in Gitter chat or any other chat platform your organization is familiar with, or they are using. Your organization may use lots of different communication platforms, but they might be active on some of them. So keep in mind to ping on all the links and communication applications they have shown, like listed to you, because they might not be using all the communication platforms. So keep in mind, you have every chance and every tool that others have. But the question is, will you succeed in this game or they will? They might get your project even when you created a prototype, you worked very hard. So keep in mind, do all the good things. Keep calm. Don't overdo things. Don't stick to people. And just keep in mind, communication is the key to getting a project. So I would like to share four rules or guidelines, you may say. Don't let the timeline fool you. Start communicating with the mentors and all the peers you find before even the organization list it will be announced, like before February 20th. Start now this is the right time. Start emailing the past mentors, or they may have listed the current mentor for the project. Many of the organizations have listed all the mentors for the projects. Asking doubt is good, but you don't have to do it just for the sake of doing it. Ask good doubts, and you can propose issues through the issues tab in GitHub. If you are finding any difficulties in installing the software, going through the tutorial, anything, just ask good doubt. The more you reach out to people, the more you know about the project itself, and you will get to know how to communicate. Even if you will not be accepted for this year, that will help you to get accepted next year. If you are in first year, second year, or third year, that might help you. So don't think your peers as your enemy. Everyone is your friend. So I already shared you my past story. That guy used all my code. So that is not how, I shouldn't be saying that he did something wrong. Open source is solely based on this pillar of sharing code, and everybody can use it. So I'm very happy he used my code, because it took a lot of time to figure out all the things at that moment. But all the time I put in doing the prototype, I may have splitted it into communication and prototype. So bit of prototype and bit of communication, I may have got the project. But okay, so the slide is over. If you have any friends who are interested in GSoC, please collaborate with them. Try to go as a team, because that will help you to look into a lot of different projects and different technologies. The chances of acceptance will be high. So if you are going alone, you have already taken a hard path with very high risk of failure. But just keep in mind, whatever you choose, it may be hard, but every step will worth the effort. You will learn a lot of things, a lot of technologies. You will learn how to communicate with people, which is very important for all the things. If you are in college, you might be sitting for the placements in your fourth year, sitting for the internships in your third year. There you can show your skills which you have learned in GSoC. So just give it a try. Don't think too much. If you are thinking about something too much, just let it go. If you cannot think your life, if you cannot imagine your life without that thing, just give it a try. You may ask, how do I go about selecting a project from the pool of hundreds of projects? It is really very simple, but it is time consuming. You will require at least, I'm sorry about the background noise. It will require you at least 1 week to get to know the project and the organization, how organization work. If you are new to GitHub, you might also consider learning to use GitHub and how to create a pull request and all those stuff. Narrow down your choice to 5 organizations, then pick one project from each organization. It shouldn't be the project they have listed for the 2020 session. It might be from 2019, so the code is already available to you, or the project is the 2019 project might not be complete, so they have listed it again. So you can go through the code, learn how the past student have done the coding and what are the things missing, figure them out. Even if you are not able to code, listing all the things you might include in the GSoC coding period will help mentor narrow down their choices for the perfect proposal or perfect candidate for the project. So just go to GitHub, find the code, list down all the things you want to include, contact the mentor, and just go about how to set up the environment, how to learn about these things. You can just ask them out. They'll help you a lot. Then communicate with mentors and developers over email, Gitter, IRC. I'll talk about IRC in the next slide, which is IRC. If you are new to IRC, it is a stripped down version of Slack. Just leave out the images part and those moving emojis part, only text and ASCII characters, ASCII emojis, wagera, emojis and other things will be like, you will be able to send only text based messages. After doing all that, narrowing your, like, first you have narrowed down five organizations, took five projects, worked on them, you communicated with mentors. Now you should also consider not choosing two projects from the five organizations you have chosen, because you can only work on three proposals. You already know that you are going to propose three projects, so leave out the two projects early so that you will not stick to them and you don't like spend all your time doing those projects which might not get accepted. I will share this presentation and you can just go to the past year organization list. There you will see a lot of there were a lot of organizations. If you are into Python, there are organizations for that. JavaScript, if you are into very easy projects related to website, simple HTML, CSS stuff, there are a lot of projects for that. If you are into high level machine learning coding, there are projects for that. Even if you are into hardware, and if you want to try to participate in GSoC for hardware based projects, you can also do that with a little bit of coding and hardware. You can submit your project in BeagleBone and I think some other robotics based organizations. You can submit your proposal related to hardware and small little bit amount of software. So internet relay chat, I have already told you that it is a way of chatting where you can only communicate using text. It is based on client-server communication protocol. So you will install a client application which will be connected to a server. Server might be Freenode. You can search about Freenode. I'll also share a link for Freenode. Most of the organizations have a channel on Freenode. You will be creating a NIC. NIC is a short abbreviation of nickname. So you'll be creating your NIC, then you can chat to anybody. There are a lot of programs for chatting on IRC. I have listed two of those which I have used, XChat and WeChat. WeChat is fully command line based. XChat is GUI version of IRC. You got to this point. We have four participants, Abdul Rahman, Ali, Raj. I think you guys are interested in GSoC. Then why not just give it a try? You are here for an experience. Let's keep the bar so high that all the other people who are also trying, but not that much, even if you fail, you'll get to know more than them. Even if you fail. That's all from my side. If you have any question, please turn on your mic. You can ask any questions you want. Even if it is related to Linux, you can ask it. You can also type the question in the chat box if you are not comfortable with. Okay, so you, Raj has asked, where can we, okay, you can contact me on Slack. My username is Lord4Linux. Okay, Ellie, do you want to ask anything related to Linux or GSoC? There are a lot of other Summer of Code competitions that are solely for girls. And they are mainly for open source contribution for software. I don't think there are a lot of Summer of Code things for, okay. Okay, Ali, are you a student? If you are a student, you can only apply for GSoC. If you are not a student, there might be other Summer of Code competitions out there for people who are not student. Okay, so I'll share a link for all the Summer of Code competitions with you. There is a GitHub repository for that. Abdul, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your name wrong. Abdul Rahman, if you want to ask anything, you can type it on the chat box or you can turn on your mic and ask me. Okay, so that's all, I think. I'm here for one more minute. If you have any questions, you can ask. Okay, Abdul Rahman. Ali, Raj, do you guys have any question? Or do you guys have any feedback for me? Because I'm still learning. I'm not very good at English and I am stuttering, I guess. Okay, that was very nice to say. Thanks, Ali. I don't know, I just want to say things, but I like skip words. I wanted to say it was very nice of you to say that, but I just skipped words. I don't know why. Okay, so you guys think this presentation is great. So I think let's call it a presentation then. If you have any question, any of you, you can reach out to me. My Slack handle is Lord4Linux. Thank you guys. Bye.